Yeah, Billy Eppard here, and I just want to let you know I appreciate you watching the vlog or YouTube, whatever you're watching on. And here's a question we got from one of the watchers that says, is there a good way to use equity from your home to fund your business? So there's primarily two ways to take equity. Of course, equity is the amount your home is worth, and you subtract then the amount you owe. So it's how much your home is worth, you subtract the amount you owe, and then typically a lender will lend you up to 80 or 90% of the value of your home. So let's say you only owe 50% on your home, and the lender will loan you 80% because now it's increased in value that much over what you owe. Then you can take 30% of it out of it as equity. So on a, let's say on a $100,000 home, you owe $50,000, and let's say the home is worth $100,000, and the lender will lend you up to a total of 80. So that's 50 that you still owe. So you have an excess of 30, that's your equity. And there's two ways to do that. One is by just refinancing your home, just refinance it and put everything in a first mortgage of $80,000. Or the second way really is to take a second mortgage on your home. And really a third way is to do what we call a HELOC. That's a home equity line of credit. Those three, so refinance your home, do a second mortgage on your home, or do what we call a HELOC, a home equity line of credit. You can take your equity out. I said there's two ways, there's really three. You take it out in those three ways, and then you can take that money and use it for anything you want. So in this case of funding your business, you can fund a business. Now, I like to take equity out and buy a piece of real estate. One reason is because the real estate actually has value, good, bad, or indifferent. The real estate never goes down to zero. Your business can actually go to zero. So you actually would lose the money you put in if it did. But one way to do it is you can do it to begin investing in real estate, a real estate business. Another way to do it is you can actually take the money and put it in your business. But remember, if your business fails, you still owe that money on your house. So just so you know that. So one of the things that I think is really important is that most Americans actually hold the most wealth that they have and that they hold is in the equity in their home. And so for you that are watching the video, if you are a homeowner, then probably the greatest amount of wealth you have is in your home. So you can take that out in those three ways and take that money and fund your business. So I think taking equity out of your home for a business, you really have to know what you're doing. So it may not be a good idea because, as I said earlier, you can actually lose the money. So another way to do it is actually what we call bootstrap your business. And I'm going to talk about this in another video, but let me just bring it in here. Bootstrapping your business is you have a good enough business idea and you have a good enough business model, which is important, that you actually can start building and bringing in revenue at the time you begin your business. So in other words, there's not this what we call delayed point of sale for your business. You actually are doing your business, you're exercising your business, you're carrying out your business, and as you do it, you get paid. So an example of that, if you're running a snow cone stand, you make the snow cone, you put the syrup on it, you hand it to the customer, and they pay you the money. Right there is the point of sale, so money's coming in. If you have to start a business that you have to wait 90 days or 120 days to get paid, it's very difficult to bootstrap that. I own some hair cutting salons, and one of the things that I liked about that was when somebody got their hair cut, they paid. I didn't have to worry about when I was going to get paid. I got paid at the time that the service was provided. And so if you're going to take equity out of your home in order to do it, you want to make sure that you are getting paid immediately at the time that it was provided. Or if you're going to take even the safer route of bootstrapping, allow the sales you make to actually pay for your business, then you're able to be able to pay for your business as you go. And many great businesses have been built not because somebody lent them $50,000. They were built out of bootstrapping. They went, they made their sales, they built themselves up, and they were able to accomplish great things by simply paying as they go, and they built a great business because of that. So So hey, thanks for watching the video. We'll see you right back here.